Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you FTP, SFTP and TFTP protocols in computer network and these three protocols that we use it for file transfer in entire computer network. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first I'll be discussing about basics of these three protocols and after that, I'll explain you how working of file transfer protocol that is there in computer network. So let us see first how many basics are there with FTP, SFTP and TFTP. See all these three protocols that we use it for file transfer in computer network, right? When we talk about FTP, then you should know full form of FTP is file transfer protocol and port number for FTP protocol that is 21. Here, my dear students, there are few basic things that you should know about FTP. Like you see here with FTP, we have two channels. One channel that is there for data and second channel that is there for command. As there are two separate channels for data and command, this FTP protocol that is referred as out of band protocol. If you have seen my last video based on HTTP, so in that I have told you, see HTTP protocol that is in band protocol. Why? The reason is data and command that is there on same channel or same connection. So here we have separate connection for data and command. That's why FTP is out of band protocol. See here with FTP, we don't provide any encryption. So data tampering is possible. Security is less that you can say. So with file transfer protocol, we don't have any encryption. And due to that, there is a possibility of data tampering and you can say it is less secure. And you should know even, my dear students, this FTP protocol that we were been using way back in 2000 and 1990s, right? See this FTP protocol that uses TCP for data communication. So you can say here communication is reliable, right? There is guaranteed data transfer due to TCP, which is there as data communication at transport layer along with FTP. Now I'm going to explain you second one, that is SFTP protocol. See, SFTP is SSH file transfer protocol. This SSH means what? Secure shell file transfer protocol. And port number for SFTP that is 22. If you observe structure of SFTP, then it is having single channel for data and command. So you can say SFTP protocol that is in band protocol. I have seen some questions comes frequently in competitive examination like SFTP that is in band protocol or out of band protocol. So you should know FTP is out of band protocol while SFTP that is in band protocol. Here there is one major difference in between SFTP and FTP, that is in band and out of band, right? So SFTP that is in band, FTP that is out of band. Here both data and commands are encrypted over here in SFTP. So you can say, see this SFTP protocol that is secured one compared to FTP protocol. Why it is secured one? The reason is here data and command both are encrypted. While with FTP protocol, there is no encryption, right? So SFTP protocol that is secured protocol compared to FTP. And nowadays we are working with SFTP protocol only, right? On computer network for file transfer, usually we use SFTP protocol. Previously in 1990s as well as in 2000s, we were been using FTP protocol. And third one is quite interesting. You see TFTP protocol. TFTP means Tribal File Transfer Protocol. It is having port number 69. See, with this protocol, we don't need to have any authentication before data transfer. See, with FTP and with SFTP, before you initiate data transfer, before you initiate file transfer, we were been having authentication process, means we will be forwarding some commands and by commands, we will do authentication. After authentication, file transfer is possible. But with TFTP, we don't need to have any authentication. And as we don't need to have any authentication, it is less secured than FTP and SFTP. And one more thing that you need to understand, see, TFTP protocol that uses UDP for data communication. See, this FTP and SFTP both are using TCP for data communication, but TFTP that uses UDP for data communication. And as we are having UDP for data communication, you have very little header over here, so data transfer will be faster one, right? But there are some issues which is there in terms of less secure as well as unreliable communication with UDP. UDP itself is an unreliable service for data communication, right? But here with TFTP we uses UDP, and remember this TFTP that we don't use it over internet. Over internet we are not using it. For file transfer with TFTP we mainly use it in LANs only. So within LAN for data transfer we uses TFTP. So in short, there are few basic things that you should know. See, FTP, that is file transfer protocol, port number, that is very essential, you will have to remember it. 21 for FTP, 22 for SFTP, and 69 that is there for TFTP. FTP is out of band protocol, means command and data both are having separate channels. Here with FTP we don't have any encryption, right? That's why it is less secure. TCP is used with FTP and SFTP. See, SFTP that is secured one. Why? The reason is both data and commands are encrypted over here, and SFTP that is in band protocol, means there is a single channel for data and command. TFTP that doesn't require any authentication, making it less secure compared to this two. As well as you should know, see, this TFTP that uses UDP, while FTP and SFTP that uses TCP. And TFTP that we don't use it over internet, we use it within LAN for data transfer, right? Now I'm going to explain you working of file transfer protocol. So here I have told you, see, FTP, that is what we are using it with two channels. One is for data and second is for command. And here first what we do authentication. See, with FTP and with SFTP, first we do authentication, after that only we transfer file, right? While with TFTP we don't need to have any authentication. So here if you observe working, then you see here we are having file client and here we are having file server. File client could be your computer and file server could be a server where we can store files. See, on server you can store file as well as from server you can access file as well, right? For that purpose we are using FTP. On server you can upload files as well as from server you can download the files or you can access the files, right? So these two purpose basically that we need to have for FTP protocol. See here, first of all, if you observe here, first step in which this file client that is giving PASV command, that is to initiate file transfer. So here at port number 21 with file server we are forwarding one command, that is to initiate file transfer. In step 2, if you observe file server, that is giving reply back. In that reply it is mentioning over the port PS1 you can transfer file. So file server is giving data related port number over which file transfer is possible. So on command file server is saying on port PS1 data can be transferred. Once that port number comes to file client can transfer data along with command, right? So transfer data means what? This file client can upload data on file server, as well as file client can download data from the file server, as well as file client can access data from the file server. See, there is a difference in between download and access. Download means you are taking complete file in your system, but access means file is there on server but you are just watching that file, you are just accessing that file, you are not downloading it, right? So all three combinations are possible over here. So here in file transfer protocol, first of all we do authentication, in which first PASV command that we forward means we are initiating file transfer. File client is saying I just wanted to have file transfer with file server. Then file server will say, okay, this is the port number over which you can have file transfer. Once that port number comes to this file client, it can initiate data transfer as per commands, right? So this is how things are happening in FTP protocol. If you want to understand working of SFTP, then only one difference that is there with this. See, here there is only single channel for data and command, right? So that is only the difference, otherwise steps will remain same. And as if you talk about TFTP, so in that we don't do authentication over a single channel, we just directly transfer data as per UDP, right? So that is how things are there. I hope you have understood this still. If anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.